Diandra Suarez, whose sex appeal, unconventional looks, and in-your-face attitude have seen her become one of the most sought-after models in India.
I think when I was 13, I saw Madhu win Miss Universe. And I said, she's like a cool girl. I guess I'd like to be like that. So in a way, Madhu's been an inspiration. And that was the beginning, I think.
She was in the 9th standard. And they had some fashion show that they did in school. I thought maybe because of her height, her good face. And that's how I was feeling. Maybe she's going to modeling.
Unlike other models, Diandra has never been afraid to try new things, whether parading the skimpiest outfits on the ramp or shocking the audience by shaving her head bald in the middle of a show.
Diandra, I remember the first memory of, I know she was a model before, but is that a cover on Avanda Femina something, makeup or something where she was bald?
That required guts, because I know I've had short hair before and you miss out on quite a lot of work, but I guess she didn't really care. I was like, oh my God, that took a lot of guts, but I think, I don't think anybody else but her could have done that.
With all the experimentation and shock value, where is Diandra Suarez most comfortable?
I love walking the ramp. I think it's an instant high. It's almost like, it's just an instant reaction.
She's got her own style. She's got her own personality. She's not one of the rat pack. That's what makes a good model a supermodel.
She's fabulous. She's stunning.
She's another one who's got this sex appeal. Whenever she's there in my show, I see to it that she gets these the most sexiest, strong clothes in the show.
Sexy, voluptuous, all women. If you are sexy and you can carry it off, then you're automatically given that option.
As a model, your job is to show off clothes. You can't turn around and say, my stomach's not in shape. If we were anywhere else in the world, I don't think you would have been a model if you had gone to your job and said, I'm sorry, I can't.
With her modeling career at its peak, Diandra still finds time to concentrate on her other interests in the fashion world.
I'm the kind of person who would want to have something else going side by side, because by the time I'm ready to retire as a model, I will have other careers.
She's great at makeup, she's great at styling, she's great at designing shoes.
It started off by me having really thin legs, so I wouldn't get boots my size. So I made a pair of boots. I said, let me just go out, buy material and make myself boots.
And no one's a model forever. And I think that it's a great talent, and I mean, I love the things I've seen her do for friends of mine.
Then I met Tarun Tahiliani, and he asked me one random night if I designed shoes for him.
Chappells that she did for me for Milan were great hit, and were copied by a lot of people from what we saw.
This was the first pair that I designed at Tarun's collection. He gave me a gist of what he wanted, and he wanted black and gold, basically. So I gave him the idea of the Kolhapuri. It's Kolhapuris with stiletto heels, and what's different is that it's a point rather than the normal round toe or the square that you normally see. These became really, really famous. My friends and co-models were like, oh my God, and they started taking boots, and I started getting orders.
I wish there were better shoe manufacturers. That's something that I would love to collaborate with her on.
I think it's great that as an individual and being a model, she can do just so much more than just walking the ramp.
See, it is so good that models can graduate gracefully and go into something new within the fashion scenario.
You know, when I was just starting off, She taught me how to put base, she taught me how to put makeup. So I think put Diandra in one word, I'd say she's perfect.
I've had an offer to style the Kingfisher calendar. I thought it was an interesting offer because I thought I was doing something new and that always seems to excite me. It's been an absolute thrill being a stylist. I've practiced it on myself. I see a lot of co-models who have great style and I keep learning new things every day where styling is concerned.
When I'm not working, this is what I usually do. I'm lazing around on this couch, my favorite position. In my quilt, and either I'm watching TV or I'm reading a book. I like to pamper myself, go to a spa, treat myself to some good massages or like a nice scrub, body scrub. I think it's important, the profession we are in also.
I've become less aggressive. I feel I've learned my lessons about not being so insecure or, you know, I know where I stand now.
She's a great friend, of course. Very supportive, very, very helpful.
I think Diandra is very bubbly, chatty. She's very animated.
She's a great friend, a great person who can listen to you and help you. She's a great person.
I'm very, very proud of her. People do ask me, you have a daughter who's a model, and when they see her pictures in the newspaper, everybody keeps calling. You know, they've seen Diandra on TV, they've seen her in Goa, or they've seen her elsewhere. I'm very, very proud of her.
So after being in this industry for so long, I need to keep my mind fresh and positive. I've learned seeing senior models who've then just gotten married and not known what to do, and I don't want to do that. I want to have a few different careers, for sure.
With her pleasant personality and creative talent, the world lies waiting for Diandra.